So I think this verse was also read last week, right? So let's see. Maybe I start with reading the verse again, and then we continue where we stopped last time, Ramini. Is that okay? Ranta dvaye pravrijata guchayugma Vibrajitena nava kanchana zorakena Shinam tutayata shodari chetitiva Badnami bostva badati dhena madhu.
Hi.
Oh, Krishodari, slender girl, your waist is so thin that I'm very much afraid that it will break when I bind it with a new golden string, shining with tassels at both ends. Oh, Krishodari, slender girl, your waist is so thin that I'm very much afraid that it would break when I bind it with a new golden string, shining with tassels at both ends. It's good if you continue from where last week they stopped. You would like to read the comments from the beginning, because last week you were not in the class because of internet.
Well, stop. Let's see.
Of course, Srimati Radhika's waist will not break so soon, but out of great unadulterated love for her Swamini, Tulsi is afraid that it will. So good, immediate question comes here for me. In the material world, we are afraid that something will happen to my beloved, no? Like if he or she is going for traveling,
yeah.
I'm worried if right. She will reach there, something happens, mm-hmm. or the phone is switched off, mm-hmm. why she's not calling, he's not calling me, right? Mm-hmm. But in the spiritual realm, Gurudev, what is this fear that Tulsi has for Swamini, that she feels that, oh my God, her waist is so thin it can break?
The beauty of the female is the slim. Why the slim? Because waist are very thin. This is the beauty. Universal truth. So Swami, the most beautiful Radhika, her waist was also very thin, and friends, they worried about the waist because it's so thin. She's so beautiful. But she's worried because she has so much to walk, she has so much to do, and so much to take care. And naughty Krishna, everything. So they are always, Manjaris are fearful that even that if I will wear the clothes to her, not trouble come to her. Means this is the so extreme love for the Manjari for Radhika, my child.
So this fear comes because of deep love.
Yeah, deep love. When the love is deep, the fear is natural. Mother has the love for deep for the her daughter, so she is very fearful when she is far from her.
Radhe, Radhe.
Yes. Uddhavji ki jai ho.
Dhandavad chahe, Gurudev. Maybe a question for you, Gurudev. Radhika's body is made of pure prema. So yeah. Tulasi's fear for the fragile body of Radhika is a kind of fear for prema.
Yeah.
Fear that this love can disappear, that it'll be come and go like that.
Radhika. Yeah. More I have to listen. Yes. Feelings are not coming. Yes. You're also right. So this is body of the love. Why she is fearful? More we have to listen.
Radhe.
Yeah.
But out of great, unadulterated love for her Swamini, Tulsi is afraid that it will break. What does love seek? Only the happiness of its object. Only the lovers can make the beloved happy. The lovers think, may you be happy. Brajera Vishuddha Prema Yeno Jabu Nada Hema Atma Sukhera Jaha Nahi Ganda. The love of Braj is as pure as molten gold.
Oh, Dhabji, this is her body was pure of love. No?
Yes, her body is prema, pure prema.
And beautiful, very beautiful. That prema is so beautiful that no other second man is there of that beauty. Mm.
The lovers think, may you be happy. The love of Braj is as pure as molten gold, and there's not even a whiff of personal happiness there in the hearts of these devotees. In Sri Radha's mood, Srimad Mahaprabhu sings, Krishna Mora Jivana, Krishna Mora Pranadhana, Krishna Mora Pranera Parana, Tridaya Uparadharo, Seva Korish Sukhi Koro, E Mora Shada Radha Dhyana. Mohan is my life. Mohan is the treasure of my life. And Mohan is the life of my life. I keep him on my heart. And I make him happy with my service.
Wow.
I always meditate on this. It says, Guru, the love of Braj is as pure as molten gold, and there's not even one whiff of personal happiness there. in the hearts of these two devotees.
Mora shukka seva ne Krishna re shukka sangha me Ateva deha dendana Krishna mora kanta kori Kohe tumi praneshwari Mora hoy dashi abhimana My happiness lies in service and his happiness lies in intimate pastimes.
Wow.
So I give my body to him. Mohan makes me his consort and tells me, you are the queen of my heart, but I just consider myself to be his maidservant. The maidservants just meditate on the pleasure of the Yugala Kishore. Sri Radhika and Sri Mohan have given themselves to each other and left all responsibilities for the arrangements of the loving affairs to the Sakis and the Manjuris. The playful Sri Yugala has taken shelter of them. Here says Gurudev, the two lovers, they have totally forgotten everything. So they have to also take shelter in the service of the Manjaris. Saying the playful Sri Yugala has taken shelter of them.
Wow.
Normally we say we should take shelter of the divine.
Our family. But they also took shelter. Why? Even the guru wants to do bhajan, they took shelter of disciples, that you take all butter and give me the chance to be, not to disturb with the material. So the Samani also and Krishna also took shelter of Manjaris, that they not bring any disturbance. They control other disturbers, that no outside disturbance come to them. Peace in that moment. So they took shelter of this house as a manjari.
You were also saying, Guru, that sometimes the disciple has to take also a burden from Gurudev to help him.
Yeah. So Guru takes shelter of the disciple. Similarly, they are taking shelter of the manjari, that they want to be peaceful, rest, no disturbance. Because they create many things more than we create. So they also want to peaceful that one. Right. They also need some time first to rest themselves from everything.
Sometimes we feel, why Gurudev is giving me this particular seva? It's not even my nature. But Gurudev can see that the disciple in this moment can help. No?
Yeah. Gurudev is also desire that disciples know this, that they can help in that service of some prayer. One of 10 disciples, one disciple ready to do that sacrifice for Gurudev. Everyone not ready. Serious disciples, that Sharanagat to Gurudev, they are ready.
Even if Gurudev then will send me away from him.
Yeah. Away is the closeness of mind. If I am far from him, means I am not thinking and not following his instruction. How I am away when I am always follow everything what he wants. Who can say that I am away from him? Living together is not closeness.
Serving together.
Yes, feeling has to be together and feel each other together from any distance can be possible. There's nothing material.
Like serving for other one always will bring closeness, no?
Yeah.
One serves together.
Yeah. If you are in the near to him temple, is also serving. If you are serving in all the creation, you see him and serve to that also is a service. Every moment you are connected there, that is the closeness. Right?
Unmadini Rai, maddened Radha. One day, Sri Radhika is going out alone to meet Mohan with merely anurag as her duty. But when she comes to the gate of the Kunja, where Mohan is waiting for her, she suddenly feigns shyness and unwillingness and asks her dutika, her messenger, "Why have you brought me here?" Even then she tries to satisfy Shyam by making him relish the mamiya rasa, the flavor of opposition. Shyam and the Sakis are very eager for her to give up this opposition, but nothing helps. The ocean of Mohan's eagerness increases and everyone feels great. The ocean of Mohan's eagerness increases and everyone feels great heartache. Gurudev, when Swamini is reaching the Kunja and then suddenly she has this change of heart, she's going in this Bamiya Ras, in this flavor of opposition, like, what does this mean?
Swami want to give more love. More. And she knows how to what he needs now. And she can feel that today Krishna comes from Chandravali. And Chandravali gives too much love. We want to catch him that you are mine. I'm yours, not I'm yours. Means I'm yours. So she and he is going to prove I'm yours. So she has to give too much love. I'm yours. You have to bring sari to me. I'm yours. You have to bring ornaments to me. Who will bring? I'm yours. Love, I love you too much. So she has to prove this. I'm yours. And she and Krishna is coming from her today. So she got the too much love. If I will give this love like normally giving, then no. He will start judging who is the best. So he said, too much sweet he eat, now I will give salty. So she knows that what Krishna likes now, what how to make happy to him. Which is tenderness is also will make greedy to him more to come to feel it. So she starts becoming little. What he's saying is Bamma, what is Bamma? Opposition. Inside, not desire is like that, but outside. Sometimes Larita said to be angry. She don't want to angry, but Larita said to become angry, so she has to become and when she become angry, then Manjari find out she is not angry because of herself. Reason of angerness is something else, Lalita. So she went to Lalita and then she requests to Lalita that please say to Swami, why she is angry, Krishna will go, that is very difficult to find him. And he after immediately she will say to go and find him where he how to find him. So say not too much agarness is good. Then she come and say that and accept it. Like that.
I was also feeling, Gurudev, that in this moment it's just about the meeting to happen and this Bama Rasya comes to Swamini's heart and the Manjaris are so excited because now they have to again engage in Seva to bring her back, to soothe her peak, and Mohan is with folding hands asking them, please help me, I don't know what I did this time, I didn't do anything wrong, why is she upset with me?
Yeah.
And in this moment, the Manjaris all can come in to this play, Gurudev, no? And can like show their expertise of serving.
Yeah.
This is also to be expert, point. How to bring...
How to make her.
The opposition again in favor.
Yeah. More service. Manjari is get it to make the favorable circumstances that they become more close, not to angry each other. this is also the job get to mandiris. For the service of senses, we have to return. This material world also, you see, we got the service to do that.
From how to make unfavorable favorable.
They don't know why they are angry themselves, they don't understand. Reason behind something is A, B, C, D, and they cannot find themselves. Yeah.
Is it, Gurudev, is it also a mood of love and separation already? The closer Swamini comes to union with her Mohan, the more she knows that there will be separation, and she's anxious, and the Manjaris are anxious with her.
Yeah, right. So beautiful, this feeling can grow many, many circumstances. And we can live like this, always in the feeling. And small thing comes and we start flowing in that pastime.
Yeah. Suniti Didi, don't hide. Today I can spot you. This is also your subject, I feel it.
My God.
Please, Suniti.
Suniti.
It's so, so beautiful, Pradeep. And what you say, Gopinath, I love this. That is all moments are always there, so our services can be more increased and more clever and more inspiring. It's all, like you say, Gurudev, to us, we have to learn to see everything positive. That is Swamini's mood. So thank you for inspiring this feeling. Very sweet.
Radhe Radhe.
Radhe Radhe.
So nice to see you, Suniti Didi. In this moment, Gurudev, nothing extra was coming to me, only that I'm relishing your words, Gurudev.
Yeah, that is the best. To live in the feeling of Swami is the best. Nothing can disturb our life. This is the best. Right.
And Gurudev, like you say, Swamini is so soft. She is so always serving everyone, that even her opposition is in service to Lalita. That is her quality, that is her love, that she always serves all her dasis, all her, you know, even gopis older. I was just thinking, Gurudev, when I was reading about the rasa dance also, in Srimad Bhagavatam, sometimes we listen over here before that a simple interpretation is that Radhika becomes Maan because Krishna is dancing with so many gopis. But I was reading it today and I feel this is not true. Actually, she loves all the gopis. She loves all the mandaris so much That's why when she was together with Mohan, has to again serve them. She goes back to them. She feels for them. She never wants to, enjoy for herself. She never wants Mohan only for herself. She is sharing. She is generous. She is full of compassion with all.
She spend herself in all gopi and all sakhis. She is the original to give the different mode to Krishna. So she want to fulfill from all the corner the love and feelings satisfying to Supreme Enjoyer, because he is also Supreme Enjoyer and she is also universal love, divine love, supreme love. And supreme satisfaction, happiness giving. So she cannot fail from her karma. And then, who is the winner? She is the winner, because in this circumstances, always Krishna loses.
But I felt this was so important, what you said, Gurudev, that when she becomes in this opposition mode, it's because she always feels for our Mohan, what he wants, what he needs right now.
Mm-hmm.
She never becomes in opposition for herself.
Mm-hmm.
Even her opposition is there to please to him.
Wow. So beautiful. She want to, not want to be a position, but to for Krishna happiness, she took this. Wow. Buddha Maharaj, Hare, I'll come in the picture.
I am there, dear.
Oh, dear. Hare.
Mohan is my life. Mohan is the treasure of my life.
Wow.
And Mohan is the life of my life.
Wow.
I keep him on my heart and I make him happy with my service. I always meditate on this.
Swami
is saying, Krishna Mora Jivana, Krishna Mora Pranadhana, Krishna Mora Pranera Parana, Hridaya Upare Dharon, Seva Kori Sukhi Koron, E Mora Sadarahe Dhyana. Mohan is my life. Mohan is the treasure of my life. Mohan is the life of my life.
Wow.
I keep him on my heart and I make him happy with my service. I always meditate on this.
Wow. This is Krishna consciousness. Right?
Yes. Yes.
Again.
Krishna Mora Jivana, Krishna Mora Pranadhana, Krishna Mora Pranera Parana, Hridaya Upare Dharan, Seva Kori Sukhi Paran, Ei Mora Sadarahe Dhyana. Mohan is my life. Mohan is the treasure of my life. And Mohan is the life of my life. I keep him on my heart and I make him happy with my service. I always meditate on this. Mora Shukha Sevane, Krishna Rashuka Sangame Mora Shuka Sevane Krishna Rashuka Sangame Gurudev.
Wow.
Ateva Deha Dendana Krishna More Kanta Kori Kohetumi Praneshwari Mora Hoy Dashi Abhimana. My happiness lies in service, and his happiness lies in Sangam, intimate pastimes. So I give my body to him. Mohan makes me his consort. Krishna More Kanta Kori Kohe Tumi Praneshwari. You are the queen of my heart. Mora Hoy Dashi Abhiman. But I just consider myself to be his maidservant.
Swamini makes Mohan live. Swamini lets Mohan live and therefore makes all living beings live. This is the power of Swamini's love and service to Mohan.
Shyam and the Sakis are very eager for her to give up this opposition, but nothing helps. Shyam and the Sakis are very eager for her to give up this opposition, but nothing helps. The ocean of Mohan's eagerness increases, and everyone feels great heartache. Everyone feels great heartache. Then Vrindavan thinks, let me once see what I can do. It is the Varsha Harsha Bana, the blissful rainy season. Or Vrindavan suddenly creates a monsoon forest with its lila shakti. And clouds are calling in the sky with deep rumbling voices, making Swamini fearfully and tightly embrace the Lord. So even Vrindavan Gurudev, the Dham, is saying, is feeling this great heartache and is saying, let me once see what I can do.
Wow.
It is the blissful rainy season and clouds are calling in the sky with deep rumbling voices, making Swamini fearfully and tightly embrace the Lord of her life. The Sakis say, blessed you are, friend, the cloud. Today you were even more clever than all the Sakis together. In this way, even the clouds of Vrindavan are blessed with the devotional service of the Sri Yugala.
All are in the service. Even the nature is in the service. Like a dasi, a radha.
That means to take shelter of the dham.
All they are taking shelter.
Because the dham can help us to increase our seva bhav.
Yeah. When we come to the dham, the dust of Radha, teach action is love, service is the love. We cannot serve without love. If the action, like you are doing the prem prasad, is responsibility. Because you, when you were a child, you go to Gurudwara, you go to only to bear service with the food. This action in the childhood comes to you, and you want to give through food, you also want to serve to all other living beings. So this childhood teachings are great teachings happening in our life. And this is the gift in our life that we learn from childhood. And then I want to do that. In the service mode. Maybe the way of different, but the subject is the same.
This morning, I was reading a verse for the Sri Prabhupada Saraswati is praying that he can always serve the divine couple in the mood of Braj. Only possible to serve in the mood of Braj?
Because in the mood of Braja, in the divine Brajabhumi, not Paham Vrindava, Divya Vrindava, it's only selfless love. Material world, personal benefit love is there. We love for my pleasure, which is the material. And we want to give pleasure to the my yesterday. That is happening on Brajapur. Pleasure for my yesterday. We not for the pleasure for myself. We do.
Selfless.
Yes, selfless. All the service, when it goes for pleasure of yesterday, that is different. This only Vrindavan can possible to realize and learn it.
So you always say, Gurudev, that everything in Vrindavan is a teacher to us. The trees are bowing down, the plants are bowing down, they're showing us the way how to have, which mood we need to enter in the service of the Yuga.
Yeah. What is normal and easy here to love, in the Western world is very difficult to understand. Possible to find it is not beyond expectation. They cannot understand it. They don't know. Then their self-satisfaction of the self. This is outer world, occidental world.
This
oriental and occidental. Buddha
can explain
what is occidental and what is oriented. You know Spanish very well.
Yes. Occidental, this means Western, European, and Oriental means Indian.
No, I don't agree this.
Deeper, Buddha, you have to go deeper in the meaning of deeper. Orient. orient ourselves.
Oh, orient ourselves. It means find direction.
Oriented means to know yourself and live in that. That is your sarup or constitutional position. This is oriented. Person do that.
And I agree.
Person do only for the sense enjoyment and for her his pleasure or her pleasure they do. That is occidental. Sridhar Maharaj books Golden of Volcano Life. Before when I start my that is I learned this teaching very nice.
So in the Occident we are the doer, but in the Orient we are the viewer. So that's why when people in Vrindavan Gurudev, you always tell them relax, sleep, take prasad, sit with me. Don't have to, but we come with this Occidental mood that we want to do everything here.
Yeah. Controlling.
You want to be a doer.
Yes, yeah. We come with the doer mentality. And then yeah. You take radically away from us. That you say, all right.
No, ready. They don't want to
radically. You take it away.
They don't want to leave this mood. They want to live in this mood.
Geist is the highest.
So maybe geist is the highest.
Occidental mood, they don't want to leave. Slowly. So much time.
Plowing.
So much. Once you try to do this, that you will understand.
Well, we said in Bhagavad Gita class, I said that the Occidental, the Western, we have only material senses, and then Oriental and Eastern, we have also spiritual senses.
That is not a person, is a practice. Is not an Indian only do. Indians also many Occidental people are. You can and Western I see many oriented people. First example is Jesus. He was not living in Occidental consciousness. Saint Francis. There are also many saintly person happen. So it depends upon the practice.
On person, practice.
Huh? And what is it? Easy way I move them. Easy situation of my living. How we balance to the Occidental circumstances and Oriental circumstances. And again, where I go back. Right, Anna? What is my real position to live?
In the soul.
Right? In my practice to live in Occidental, I will go for 5 minutes, 1-2 minutes, and again come to the Occidental. That is to do sadhana. This is sadhana. It's not outside doing his sadhana that I do 1 hour, 15 minutes, bhajan or two. 24/7 we have to do the sadhana to come out from Occidental to inner consciousness. Yesterday, yes. Suniti write one place. in the name of my book. I don't know. I cannot say these things. But she said, mental exercise, someplace I mentioned, is a mental exercise means exercise to the mind. How we can do the exercise to the mind? This is bhajan. Mental exercise of the mind is to keep mind one-pointed. Like if one ghost want to do something, then he went to his Gurudev, he said to you, this ghost, to put the oil in the one bamboo and say to go up and down, go up and down, go up and down.
On a bamboo stick.
Bamboo stick. So the ghost come, give me the work, if not then I will kill you. He said, okay, your work is to put the oil in the one bamboo and put it in the courtyard and go up and down. This is the exercise of the mind. Go up and down, go up and down, but in one bamboo, not outside many bamboos. Mind will search many bamboos. Only this bamboo you have to stay and go up and down. Because of the oil, he tried to go up too long time it takes. And then again slippery is also 1 second. So he has to go up again slowly. This exercise is a bhajan kriya. Mental exercise. I see myself sometimes, if I'm thinking and talking something else and doing bhajan, then what chanting? It happens different chanting. I say, what? I'm doing the mantra, this, how this come? Because the mind is not there. The mind need exercise to keep one mind at one bamboo, not jump to other bamboo. Apne dil se jaano paraye dil ka haal. You have to practice and watch yourself and see the how the this jumping is, jumping to the other bamboo. I say stay here, then they jump there. I am chanting this mantra, I jump to other mantra. Wrong way I am chanting. I watch, really, you watch. Be careful. Strongly, she's worried that I wake up at 3, I wake up at 2. Are, I have to do the exercise, old man, I have to do more exercise. Vinod Rao say you have to be
intense.
How intense will happen? I'm happy she is going, that I can do some intense.
But even afternoon when you lie down, you have to do exercise over there. Nobody cannot rest.
When you have a too much practice, automatic going. But really I'm fearful with her that she, I know, open the light and everything. Idingly sitting here. Mobile, why are you going? To help me. You see, she's angry. I said good thing for her.
So, when one is so close in love, Gurudev, when the disciple has so much love, then also sometimes he goes in opposition, just to increase the love.
You see, now she went to anger. Now. I said, I'm worried that she loved me so much that she will be angry while you're doing it. Yes, today she said that your mind is not working. Why? Because you're not sleeping. I said, you're right. I watch. I have to say some word and I start thinking what to say. I forget the word even.
No.
Yeah, before today.
I cannot remember the word, what is Hindi, English.
That one calls one pointed mother. You only one pointed.
You see, she becomes angry. It's a good thing, but she thinks that I am talking about her.
She's just in separation from you.
Only lovers can do this.
Yeah. She's too much sad.
She's sad.
Today, even Vrindavan gave the monsoon clouds. And the rain to cool down this feeling of separation. Never in May we have a rain like this.
Vrindavan thinks, let me once see what I can do. It is the blissful rainy season. Vrindavan suddenly creates a monsoon forest with its lila shakti, and clouds are calling in the sky with deep rumbling voices, making Swamini fearfully and tightly embrace the Lord of Vrindavan.
What is lila shakti? Lila Shakti means to give the pleasure to the Lord. And who is this Shakti? This is Swamini Shakti, Lila Shakti, Radha Shakti. In all circumstances, want to make happy to his lover. This is the job of the Lila Shakti. Everything is the one pointer how to make happy to her. Not for personal happiness and desire. This we can see only in Vrindavan.
Gurudev, I think what you say is a very nice example that our mental exercise must be so strong, ideally, that the occidental becomes accidental.
We do the reverse. Occidental makes the accidental.
It should be the other way around. And then Swamini also, because she is because Swamini Gurudev is your mind, is your heart, is your feeling, and she will let you forget all the words you don't need in your life.
One thing more, my Uddhav Baba said, she is only love. Feeling means only she is the. Everything is of love. That is Swami. And his light. Nothing material. All the mind is with love. Heart is the love. Heart. West. What is what is the West? Is also very thin.
Thin.
Is also with the love. Everything is only to give love. That is my song. Not for her pleasure, she thinks.
Everything is so tender and soft, Swami.
Yeah.
So the maidservants also have to have this softness and tenderness.
Without that, they are not maidservants. If the maidservants say, and this Muri is not there, how they are maidservants? Is only then we are only expecting, but we have not practicing.
Mm. Well, we're only expecting, not practicing.
Imagining.
Mora Shuka Sevane, Krishna Rasuka Sangane.
Oh.
Ateva Deha.
My happiness to Seva.
Yes.
And Krishna Praja
Sangame.
Sangha. To assist the Sangam.
Two rivers come together, we call the Sangam, no?
Sangam.
The unification
meeting. He wants to give that meeting because my mood of the service, he wants to be give this mercy of meeting. Desire he fulfills.
Krishna Mora Kanta Kori Kohe Tumi Praneshwari Mora Hoy Dasi Abhimana. He tells me, you are the queen of my heart, but I just consider myself to be his maidservant.
Wow.
So Gurudev is Swamini here also in kind of a kinkari bath.
Swamini is the Krishna conscious. Krishna consciousness. She don't know she is Krishna or Radha. She don't know out of Krishna. This is so. She forget herself to know that she is a Radhika. She is so much to be with Krishna that her eyes become blue. Her all mind is Krishna-mai. She is always with Krishna. But she is Krishna-mai. That we don't need to be a Krishna-mai. We have to be, Manjari has to be Radha-mai. She is teaching with her lover that if you love your lover, you have to be also that. Some teachers that you have to be like Radha. So Radha is Krishna-mai, you also become Krishna-mai. So where we want to be? We cannot be a Radha. Anyone can be Radha? We can be a Dasi of Radhika. We can learn from Radhika. Right?
Wonderful. We also have the blue eyes, Gurudev, but because we always see Swamini.
Yeah.
Her blue eyes.
That is the meaning of the blue eyes. You see Narada. So much close with Radharani. She has the blue eyes.
Mm. Wow.
What is the meaning of that blue eyes? Means you have to be only 24/7 to keep in the eyes of Swami. Yes, yes.
So that if I want to serve someone fully, I have to know each and every feeling, movement of that.
Then knowing, na.
Then
if I don't,
how to
don't know each and every part of and four of you, how I know you?
How can I serve?
And if you are female and I want to be like a male, then I can serve you. So first I have to change my enjoy tendency to the female tendency to serve the female. Male cannot sincerely be a dasi of the female. How you can give massage if you are male? Because of the ego of the male body, some dirtiness can come. So bhav has to change first, right?
In this way, even the clouds of Vrindavan are blessed with the devotional service of the Sri Yuvara. This is the first meeting described by the great poet Kavi Karnapura after he sucked the nectar out of Sriman Mahaprabhu's tongue. Again, sometimes Shyam is helpless and finds no other means to meet Radhika but to take shelter of the Manjaris.
Wow.
Again, sometimes Shyam is helpless and finds no other means to meet Radhika but to take shelter of the Manjaris.
What happened when she stopped the entrance to Krishna? Then Krishna is praying to the Manjaris, please find out the way that I can meet. Hanuman will try to help her. Sira.
The Kinkaris know the grace and the beauty of the Yugalapna.
Wow. What Kinkari knows?
The grace and grace. The beauty of the
grace. Who give the grace? Swami give the grace to Mandir. That grace comes from Radhika. She gave much. Kripa is coming from her. That is grace. And beauty is coming from Krishna. And what is his beauty? He wants to unite. He wants to sambhog with us. Means he wants not to leave us. Sambhog means he wants to catch us. We want to catch him, it's not possible. But when he wants to sambhog us, meet us, then we cannot be. That is the good. Devotional practice, Bhagavad Gita, 12th chapter, 13, 14 to 20. What is devotion? Is mentioned only in 6th sloka. That Krishna say, you are my dear, I will not leave you. But his meaning, he wants to leave me. We don't want to leave me. Who is talking?
Somebody was just by accident.
So, Sambhogman, he wants to not want to leave. He wants to, he is so liking that he wants to be inside, to be with her. But does he want only to live with Ramne? So what he can do? He takes after Kinkari. That is also closeness of is not material sambhog, is a divine sambhog meeting.
So Gurudev, can we say that on the highest level of perfection of the Kinkari, she can give this feeling of oneness with Mohan to Swami?
That's the point. That is the meaning of sambhog with the Manjari means he gives that feeling that Krishna can feel and she can organize all the meetings with the Radhika, all the things without her not possible. So 12 and 12 is there, without half, nothing works.
That is so sweet and amazing, Gurudev, really. What a meditation.
So we, if we are not had the love to serve my Swami, of course, his lover, we will not try to be happy, we want to try to be a full one. So then there is no acceptance. We have to become half, then we have an acceptance out there. Till I want to be full, then we are one. Then no place there. Only qualification is to be become half. Right? Meditate and think on that.
Radhe Radhe Gurudev. So
it's time us.
ありがとうございます。Yeah. So, Manjari never want to become friend with Swamini. Manjari always be her dasi because they want to be half of her. They never become perfect. Is this correct?
You save me, I don't know. I'm trying to...
Just come to my heart. We are half. If we become friends, same position, it's not test for Manjari.
No. Then we are full. The Manjari, but Manjari identification is to be half. Our nature to be a full. When its nature will become half to be, then we will become Manjari. Normal position. There's nothing to effort.
Half means we need original. Without original, half cannot live.
Institutional position was this. Then we cover myself with the mother, when there was one flash. Then we pray to the Lord that I want to take the birth in this flash, because to take a form. Then Lord says, he's a dog monkey, why you want to take the dog form? No, I want to take dog form, because without form I know that nothing I can do. Sometimes this flash is in the pig form, body. And we are so tired with the living in the without body, we want to take pig body. We are so fortunate that this time we got the human body. And the luckiest point that we can also visit Vrindavan. We have a desire and interest with the spiritual master. He guides us that you can find it or many things in Vrindavan. And my body is also visiting Vrindavan. But my body is visiting, but I'm still flying up the Vrindavan. Still not landed here. Flying. Why are you flying? Landing means when you land, only you think for here. But we are flying, we think so many things. Mind is so much full with other desire and thinking that we are not landed to Vrindavan. My desires are many things, I don't know but how to balance. When we will land and we want to develop love and relation with my study, then I landed to now. Kill this desire. We are only still in flight from the outside. Not like or I become tourist to tour and go back other place. But not landed means you become not in that circumstance. Then you see the Bhom Vrindavan. Not you are satisfied with Bhom Vrindavan. You want to go to Divya Vrindavan. Then you really see with your bhajan Bhom Vrindavan and Divya Vrindavan. And then you enter in the pastime of radha, you are still there. Mm-hmm. This is all happened by one Guru Manjari Kripa. Yeah.
Gurudev, there is this, always I love this scene when one day Radharani is approaching Tulsi and saying, Hare Tulsi, I make you my friend, come, I give you the position of friendship, you can become one of my yudhishthiras. I make you my Sakya. And that Tulsi looks